grew up with Gary. And each of us Gary drank from a young age, about 16, insecure, trying to be the cool kid. One day, the young team said, make some noise if you like cocaine. And I've done cocaine before, I thought something like it would have been cool. I was like, bruh! We got cocaine! The MC said, cocaine is for dickheads! And everyone else was like, bruh, bruh, fuck cocaine, dickhead! Ruined any chance of going to him and thought, wow, great technique on this crap. I also like the way that Gary tried to advertise. There were cool things like sexy and stylish, but then the radio advert included a list of items that you couldn't bring to the place, which made you suspicious as to how sexy and stylish the clientele were really going to be. No hats, no tracksuits, no gloves, no better clavers, no nail files, no slingshots, no swords. After Gary showed grime, also a big fan of grime. Best thing for me about grime, when grime entities call out their name as their friend, we were in prison to appeal to have them released. They hit him a second like, yo, free young spray, free Desi, free my brother Butt Kate. As if the Home Office are tuning into pirate radio at 2 o'clock in the morning to make their release decision on the basis of a list of increasingly dangerous animals. The other day I heard an MC say, on a real, free my brother Warlord. And then his mate chipped in and said, yeah, nobody's perfect. And then I could defend. So yeah, grew up as a vegetarian and then growing up solid. So if you're vegetarian, you see how proud you are these days. I was a vegetarian for 22 years. I was a vegetarian in the 90s, but it wasn't, you couldn't vote, you know, we had to hide it on dates. Nowadays, women having babies with vegans, like it's a fashion statement, and have a child with mixed dietary heritage. Oh, it's gorgeous, Kat. What's this mix? Half white, half gluten-free. I did a gig the other day in 2011, and I asked that question if there were any vegetarians in the crowd, and the room felt silent except this one conflicted roadman who was screw-facing me all night, and he went, "Prah!" And I said, vegetarianism is for dickheads! And everyone else was like, bruh, bruh, bruh! I didn't say that it was massive, but it wasn't a strangely violent way to confirm being a vegetarian. Because it's not like I said, yeah, I'm a vegetarian, but don't get it twisted, I'm not putty. It's all butts, my gun. They did come up to me after the race with Biden, but I think the world was being environmentally conscious on the roadside. I've been carrying a knife ever since I started recycling in 2008. A couple of men have to stick me up and it's always separating paper from plastic. Have you raised by a single mum? Give me a cheer. Can you raise your hand? I didn't see the audience. No one. Yeah. Did your mum ever have a boyfriend you didn't approve of? What would you do if that had happened? You visited it. What is the British nation was doing again? That's horrendous. My mum has a new boyfriend. I don't like this guy myself. So I teach him a lesson. I fell asleep with his mum. He's not into it. Things have become much more tasteful between myself and this guy since we both applied to the council to adopt each other. He applied to adopt me. I retaliated. Both applications were successful. He's now my adopted father. I'm his adopted father. He's his own father's father. He's his own. He's his grandfather. But my sex life is not just about, you know, revenge sex and other cool stuff is going on. I've got a flip gift during sex. I say, you know, I'm killing it in the bedrooms. How many of you suckers can say you've had sex with someone so thoroughly, now you need an injection in your spine to achieve a tolerable quality of life? Rather than sex with a slip disc, they'll be revived. You've got to keep the pillow talk sexy. And he says, wow, I want to put this. You say, yeah, I'm also experiencing localized pins and needles in both my arms.